Oh my god. We've just hit 10,000 followers. Oh my god, I can't even believe it. Thank you guys. I can't even believe 10,000. Oh my god. Thank you guys so much. I can't even tell you how much it means to me. Oh my god, I love you all so much. Thank you so much. And thank you to my amazing boyfriend, Luke. I couldn't have done any of this without you. I love you so, so much. Thank you, all of you. Oh my god. You look so pretty. Oh, thank you. Thank you. You've just hit 1 million followers. Oh my god, guys, I just hit a million followers. Oh my god, thank you so much. I love you all so much. I really appreciate it. It's about time. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I love you all so much, Fat Anakins. I really appreciate it. I love you all.
Oh shit, 5 million. Ugh, better do a video then.
Oh my god, guys, we've just hit 5 million followers. Thank you all so much. I can't tell you how much it means to me. I love you all so much. It's because of you very people that I'm happy every day and I get to do what I love, which is entertain all of you beautiful people. I love you, my Anakins. Bye.
To anyone who says that being TikTok famous isn't real fame, tell that to the 5 million people who wake up and immediately check my page just to see if I posted anything new. I mean, as great as it is, it does come with its struggles. I have to be at the top of my game every day, post the right stuff at the right time, ugh, and promote disgusting clothes and face care. I have to keep my appearance up, diet till the end of my days, because if I put so much as £1 on, someone's got something to say about it. Don't get me wrong, I love what I do. I post a picture a day on Instagram and money goes straight into my pocket, simply for promoting something as small as an earring. And it has taught me some beneficial skills, like how to do convincing editing and what looks good, what poses are the most liked and which ones aren't sexy enough for the creeps in my DMs, what the right and wrong things are to say to people, but let's be real. No one's got anything bad to say about me. I'm too famous. Instead, they're going to ask for a picture. Being a social media star is basically a full-time job. Every day of my life is strictly planned out so that I can post the right amount of content at the right time, so I can get the best results. I have spent ages working out the algorithm and using it to my advantage so that my videos always get on the For You page. Not going to lie, social media has made me analyze myself a bit more. I mean, I'm still gorgeous, but there are some things I'd just like to change. Like, ugh, I've always hated my nose. I'm saving up at the moment to get a nose job done. I always slim it down on Photoshop, but I've got to be careful it's not too noticeable, so people don't notice in real life that my nose looks completely different. Of course, I edit it because if I didn't edit it, I'd get insulted, but if people see that I do, they'd call me fake. You can never win on social media. Someone's always got something to say. Like how if I wear makeup, I'm full of myself and a catfish. But if I don't wear it, I look ill or depressed. Ugh.
Hi, Leanne. Today is photoshoot day. Hopefully you will like the items as much as we do. We would like one Instagram photo
and two TikToks from this package. package also includes photos of models demonstrating to you the exact way we would like them to be seen on the Instagram post. Thanks, Arsehole Clothing Brand. Ugh.
Brands are my biggest income source. I don't care if they are the ugliest clothes I have ever seen. And, you know, they usually are. No wonder they want me to show them off to the world and trick people into buying their clothes. They can get a bit dodgy though, these brand deals. Sometimes they'll tell me specific poses to be in for the Instagram photos. They can get really sexual, but hey, money's money. Who can complain? Even if I did complain, everyone would just say how easy I have it compared to others. I guess they're right. It turns out everyone was right when they said that social media can turn on you in an instant. One sly comment, one hateful rumour, one shady tweet, one attacking YouTube video and...
Hey guys. As many of my subscribers will know, I was in a relationship with Leanne Atwood for a year and a half. I'm making this video today to expose Leanne for her toxic and abusive behaviour that caused me to end our relationship. And unfortunately, I have to tell you that you do not know the real Leanne. At the beginning of the relationship, it was lovely. We both supported each other's ambitions to grow on social media, and we would give each other video ideas to make sure we were putting the best of ourselves out there. And this made me blind to the fact that she used me on how to get information to gain followers and get popular on social media. And then when she outgrew me, she became toxic and entitled to the point where she'd constantly insult me, telling me I had to gain more relevance to spend time with her, her TikTok friends on days out or at parties. She also doesn't care about her followers the way you think she does. She views them as pawns in her game of fame and tools to get her name out there and gain more followers. I know this sounds bitter considering we've just broken up, but I've been telling Leanne this for months. And these following screenshots prove that I've constantly been telling her and she has continually ignored me. I believe it is time to show the world the real Leanne. The Leanne who is selfish, manipulative, vindictive and cruel. I am by no means saying that I am perfect, and in the past I have not shown some elements of these qualities, but I hope you guys know that I have learned from this and you can see that in my videos. I hope this causes other people to come forward who have had similar experiences to me, including, and I quote, unworthy friends. They will show that Leanne doesn't deserve her platform and should move aside to a creator who does deserve her fame due to her talent, ambition, creativity and down-to-earth spirit, who will use their platform for good. Thank you for listening.
We were messing around and I jokingly threatened that I was going to post an embarrassing photo of her. She said, "Don't you fucking dare, you stupid bitch, or I'll ruin you."
She told me not to get my hopes up in getting popular on TikTok because I wasn't pretty enough.
She told all my friends that she couldn't understand how any of them could stand me.
From personal experience, I know all of what Lucas said is true because she has treated me the exact same way. When we first met, we were getting along really well until she went home and learnt that I had 10,000 followers and I never heard from her again.
She said to me that I should make content that appeals to a younger girl audience by being really pretty and skinny, like a Barbie doll, so that they want to be like me.
Please don't do this. I'm working on an apology video right now. We're going to sort it all by the end of the week. This brand deal is my income. I can't deal without it. Please, can you just wait for the reaction for the apology video to come out? I'm literally begging you. I have been nothing but good to you. How much of your sales gone up because of me? This is all I have. Please don't take it away from me. I did everything you asked. I posted exactly how you wanted me to. I gave you glowing reviews. Are you really going to treat your best representative like this? Fine. Good luck finding someone as obedient as me.
I didn't know they could leave this fast. Luke was right. Once his video went up, multiple more came. I just thought that I, of all people, would be safe. I mean, I tick all the boxes. I'm pretty, I'm funny, I'm relatable, I'm cute, I'm intelligent, I'm consistent with my videos. I'm basically perfect. Am I missing something? What more could you want in a social media star? To be honest, it's probably just jealousy. I mean, I don't blame them. I'd be jealous of me too. Ugh. And you know what? Sometimes the online world just sucks. Especially when people decide they're going to expose you, even when you've done nothing wrong. But we live in a society that loves to hate. It gives people an excuse to focus on something apart from their own miserable lives. Apology videos are an oxymoron in themselves. When I post it, people won't like it. And all the drama channels will post about it, saying how awful it is. But if I don't post one, the hate builds up and I'm evil for not addressing these comments and not saying sorry for the things I've been accused of.
Hello everyone. Well, this is a video I never thought I'd be making. So, I'm guessing most of you are here because you know as much as I do that I need to address the videos that have been circulating around YouTube over the past week. I also need to apologise for the actions that I've been accused of. But before that, however, I would like to thank my family, my amazing friends, and my amazing Anakins for always supporting me during these hard times. I really, really appreciate it, and I love you all so, so much. You're the best. The videos, of course, that I am talking about were started by a video that my ex-boyfriend, Luke, posted, where he accused me of being horrible, basically, during our relationship. Let me make one thing quite clear. He said in his video that none of you know the real me. I mean, first of all, my diehard fans will know that I am always 100% authentic on my videos. Well, look at me right now. I'm not looking my best. I post videos of me upset because I want my fans to know it's okay to be upset sometimes. You don't always need to look perfect online. I also have never and will never Photoshop any of my Instagram photos because I know how damaging that can be to young, impressionable girls and their self-esteem and self-image. I would never do that. Second of all, how do you know that Luke is who he presents himself as? I know things about Luke that would shake you to the core. I could take messages between me and him, take out all the context, remove myself from the conversation, and make him look like a complete prick. But no, because I respect his privacy. Even though he spat on mine and doesn't even care. And as to the other relevant people, who most of them I believe I've only spoken to maybe once or twice, how dare you have an entitled view over me when you don't even know me? Did you ever think that maybe when he was messaging me that I might have been having a bad day? Or I might have been a little blunt because of other things happening in my life because my world doesn't revolve around you? No, of course not. We all know that sometimes in a text message, things don't come across properly, do they? If I said it to them in person, it would have been fine. This would have all not happened. But no, they didn't respect me enough to message me about their grievances towards me and ask me what was going on. I would have happily messaged them back and sorted things out. But no, you wanted your 5 minutes of fame, so you took my good name for views and followers. And as for the accusations that Luke has got against me, I'm sorry if my style of humour offends you. Banter. I don't know if you've heard of that phrase before, Luke. Actually, no. I'm fully aware that you have heard of that phrase. We did it all the time. Like I said earlier, he completely took it out of context. He did it to me. It was a mutual thing. But no, he lost his famous girlfriend. Now he is lacking and losing the followers. So he's thinking, who can I blame all my problems on? Who can I use to get followers? I know. I'm gonna say Leanne's a bitch. Well, I'm sorry. No, I'm not. I've done nothing wrong. I don't know what you're talking about. He also said in his video that I never invite him to gatherings that I had with my friends, primarily from TikTok. It was a close group of friends because we were all prominent on the app.
I'm sorry if I didn't realise that I have to drag my boyfriend along to every social event I go to. I'm sorry. No. I can do what I want. I can go with whoever I want, because I can tell you for a fact that if I was meeting up with a group of friends from, say, primary school, he would have no problem not coming. He would actually think it'd be weird if I just said, "Hey Luke, do you want to come out with me and my friends from 10 years ago?" He'd be like, "No, what the hell?" But as soon as it involves people that can maybe bring his image up a bit, famous people, people who could give him a shout out or have collaborations with him, I'm suddenly cruel. Okay, so I hope this video clears up some of them awful rumours about me, and that soon we can all move along. Thank you for listening. Make sure you keep updated on my YouTube and my TikTok. I post every Friday on YouTube and every day on TikTok. Also, check out my Instagram down below. If you like all of my photos, you might get a follow from me, you might get a DM, who knows? I love you all, my Anakins. I hope I'll see you next Friday. Bye! Okay, let's just cut the bullshit. I don't want to be here. There's nothing you can say to me that I don't already know. And before you start with all the therapist stuff, I know what I need to do.
I just need to remind myself that I wasn't always like this, and that I didn't always need the followers.
I just wanted attention from someone. Is that really such a crime?
Why do you think that is, Paige?
I don't know. You're the therapist. You're supposed to be telling me, isn't that your job?
How's your relationship with your parents?
Fine.
Any siblings?
Sister.
Older?
Yeah.
Listen, Paige, you know how you said it was my job to be a therapist? Well, that can only work if you do your job, which is open up to me. I'm not here to snitch on you to your parents or to judge you. I'm here to help. I'm here to help you understand the feelings you may or may not be experiencing, and to help you find ways to cope with that. I'm on your side. Please remember that, Paige, because I have no reason not to be. Okay? So, how would you describe your relationship with your parents?
I don't know.
I don't know them. They don't know me. The only thing we both know is that I will never be better than Emily.
We kind of just leave it at that and keep ourselves to ourselves.
What do you think makes Emily better than you?
She's smart. She's pretty, but not too revealing.
She doesn't like to party. She reads books. She cooks. She cleans. She's generous. She's selfless. She loves her parents, and they love her so much.
So much they have no problem reminding me of that. I'll walk downstairs, and there's no photos of me, just her. Like I shouldn't even exist.
Well, you had a successful TikTok career. Surely that's one thing you can be proud of.
It was fake. All of it. I never cared about the likes or the followers. It was just meaningless numbers on a screen. And the attention was from the wrong people. I just wanted a mum and a dad who cared about me and loved me for who I am. Is that too much to ask? Well, I didn't have that, so I just filled the void with people who loved what I chose to show them.
And even the hate that they gave me was filled with more passion than a lifetime of emotions my parents ever showed me. So I thought that maybe if I became something online, people worshipped me, that I'd forget.
feel good enough. And I did, for a brief second. I felt important. Like the whole world loved me and I was worthy of that love and attention. But then, one click of a button and it was all gone. It was like I was falling down a well with no rope to hold on to. There was nothing I could do. I was nothing. Again, nobody. Another grain of sand on a beach, being pushed around in the breeze, and it's soothing to everyone else.
No one noticed me anymore. I was another patient on your list, another girl walking the street, another student, another neighbour, another girl born in 2002.
A waste of space. Again. An unlovable, disappointing daughter. Well, anyway, I mean, loads of people feel like that deep down, and, you know, I'm sorry I complain to you when there's people in countries starving, countries in war, and I'm just sorry. And anyway, I mean, I've still got my health, and, you know, I've still got good friends, and I'll be off to, you know, I'll be off to university soon. I can reinvent myself and find a new hobby that will bring me as much joy, you know, and then I'll be, you know, happy again.
But were you actually happy?
First day on set. Let's go. Yeah.
Well, we've just recorded. We've recorded the same scene like 5 times. First time we did it, we were facing wall. We had the front camera on, so it was just facing the wall. The second time we did it in slow motion. And every time we've just either not been in shot properly. We're not very good at this.
Ooh. That's what I'm talking about. That's the tear action. Look at it dripping. It's like all of my trousers. Look at that.
There we go.
Draw it on. She's really sad. Okay. Well, now that they're here, I'm gonna block them out. There we go. Blottage. I love yellow. What the hell?
Ew.
What?
This is my phone.
Ew. No me gusta.
Get in the zone, Carol.
No. We did it. We just hit 1 million followers. Wait, hang on. We're doing it the wrong way.
What do you mean?
I thought we were going to do it this way. I thought we said that at first. We've changed it to that way.
Okay.
Because all the rest of it is...
Anywho.
Well, behind the scenes, day something. Oh my god, I lost the chair. My skin is not loving the amount of makeup I'm putting on it every day. Leanne is full of this. Look at this. Look at that. Mm-mm. Buddy's here too.
Anya.
Hey. Oh, I'm correct.
Good boy.
Yeah.